Chicago is out?
The fact that a contingent from Chicago got out politicized, boy, that is a double stomach punch.
It's a tremendous blow to not only those in Chicago, but it also will call into question the considerable efforts by the president and the first lady going over there.
Whether Obama factored into it or not, whether there's anti-Americanism.
Chicago is out?
I couldn't believe it.
Yeah.
Well, I still can't believe it.
Now to get outdone on insider politics.
The energy and the air really went out of this crowd just a few seconds ago.
The air went out of that balloon real fast.
Chicago is out?
Whatever the case is, this is a great city, man.
Wait a minute. Chicago is out?
Chicago, Chicago.
It is the Savage Nation. I can't say I'm celebrating. I'm not celebrating at all. It's just another blow to Obama's ego and to the Chicago aldermen who thought that they had, with a president in their pocket, the world in their pocket. Apparently the world told Obama to take a hike. That's all. They said you could take that TV star host that you have and the first lady and you and take a walk. Now, it's astounding to me that no one said anything about the fact that the president of the United States, the leader of the free world, doesn't have the time to meet with General McChrystal, who's stuck over in Afghanistan without sufficient troops or weaponry, a man who says health care is his number one priority, a man who has not fixed the economy, the unemployment rate is rising. I mean, this guy goes over there, and they treated him like a rock star when he got there, and then they gave him a screwing. Because they don't really actually think he's much. They actually think he's facile, empty, an empty suit. He's an empty suit. The world knows it. Now, that's one way to look at it. There's no other way to look at it, except if you want to put rose-colored glasses on the fact that Obama's hometown of Chicago has been thrown out of the Olympic quest, which is all about graft anyway. The reason the most Chicagoans were split on this, you know, about even, is because they knew that, A, they'd pick up the bill no matter what they told them, and B, they wouldn't be able to get to work because of the crowds on the public transportation. But what was the taxpayers' burden for this little outing? Here's a man who said, quote, when he ran, "I have done more to take on lobbyists than any other candidate in this race, and I won. I don't take a dime of their money, and when I'm president, they won't find a job in my White House." That said Hussein Obama. Now, he has five lobbyists in his cabinet, and he just lobbied for Chicago. He's much worse than Bush, and Bush was horrible. Talk shows, trips to the Olympic Committee, not one conversation in 70 days with our military chief in Afghanistan. Nothing on health care. No health care plan. And no one knows why we're in Afghanistan. Now, the real story may be something different than what I'm saying. We don't really know the real story. They go to the IOC. What's the IOC? Does anyone know what the IOC is? Raise your hand. The International Olympic Committee. Who are they? They're as corrupt a body as Tammany Hall ever was. You have to smear them, pay them off. And apparently there wasn't enough money in this or enough boys and girls in it for them to have said yes to Chicago. Instead, they chose the sex-drenched capital of Brazil to host the Olympics. So, you know, if I were an Obama supporter, I'd spin it and say, our president here, they'll listen to this now. This will be stolen by not only by the hem, but this will be picked up by ABC, CBS, and all the others who say I don't exist. Here it is, boys and girls, since you don't have brains enough to have thought this for yourself. Listen, the schmucks in the media were so blindsided by this rejection that they were just stunned like the old deer in the headlight. Lost? No Chicago? No Chicago? Oh, get me a pill. Get me my therapist. They could have figured this out. They could have spun it in Obama's favor. If I worked for Obama, here's what I would have said. Because I'm a talk show host. The truth is that I give you my truth and no one else's truth, and that's the whole truth. The truth is I give you my truth. That's the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. It doesn't matter whether it's your truth, his truth, my truth, that truth, all aboard. All that matters is it's my truth. So here's my truth, is that if I worked for Obama, I was one of the Pratt boys in the media who was falling all over the stage for Obama all these months and years now, what I would have said was, the IOC is so corrupt that Obama is so uncorrupt that he couldn't sell it because he wasn't willing to give him a bribe. They wouldn't, but they're not smart enough. They can't think on their feet. You do know the IOC is a bunch of corrupt internationalists. The International Olympics Committee, you forgot already what happened last time. You forgot about this. You forgot about the Atlanta and Salt Lake City IOC bribery scandals. You forgot about that. In other words, they didn't get schmeared properly. Maybe the gang and leaders of Chicago didn't even want to spend any of the large. I mean, I don't know how it works. Maybe there's a certain percentage they have to pay. It's like a slotting fee in a supermarket. In other words, maybe it works out this way. The IOC lays it out. I'll tell you what, we want, 8% off the top, the VIG, off the top of the gross. And maybe Chicago is offering 3. And maybe they try to negotiate 4, and they said, take a walk. Brazil is offering us 8. Goodbye, Charlie, and that's it. I don't know how it works. No, I don't know anything. I know nothing. No, I know nothing. I know nothing. I'm so dangerous that I know nothing. In other words, I know nothing to such an extent that a government would ban me from their country. That's how stupid I am. If I know nothing, why would Britain ban me? If what I say is so horrendously useless and meaningless, how come I'm banned in Britain? How come Rush Limbaugh gets the job of judging a Miss America and I get the job of speaking before the Cambridge Union in a debate? What does that tell you about America today? Nothing. You can't put 2 and 2 together and not come up with 4. So there it is. I don't know. You think this says anything about Obama's presidency, whether good or bad? Yes, they were voting on Obama, and they gave him a 0. They gave him a 0. Lofty vision, grandiloquence, lots of speeches, flies to Denmark. He takes a talk show host with him, who everyone thinks is a god. I never watched a day in my life. God should strike you dead if I'm lying. I have not watched Oprah Winfrey for more than in passing in my entire life, a total of 4 minutes. I have not watched David Letterman a total in my life more than 3 minutes. I have not watched Jay Leno a total in my life more than 3 minutes. I have to watch him as I'm clicking by for something more entertaining. But I understand she's important and powerful to people who stay at home and watch welfare and collect welfare checks. Now, why would you think that Obama would think that Oprah Winfrey would convince the Olympic Committee that this is a good place to go, Chicago, because she went there? You'll notice there wasn't one white person on the trip. I'm sorry to say it to you. Did you notice that? Now, that's another card that the left hasn't played. They could spin this now and say that you heard one of the schmucks in the media say, well, they rejected it because they're anti-American. Now it's anti-American? They just loved us last week because he gave up the missile shields. He threw Czechoslovakia and Poland under the bus. He kissed the Saudi kings behind. He bowed down to Putin. They've loved us all over the world till now. Now what, it's anti-American all of a sudden? You could say it's racist if you're a liberal. But you wouldn't get away with it because they chose Brazil. Darn. Darn, had they only chosen a white country with blue-eyed men, then you could have said, well, it's because he was a black president. Can't use that card. What can you use? All you could use is that it's a judgment of him by the delegates in Copenhagen who really shook his hand, treated him like a rock star, and then humiliated him. That's all. This was not a narrow defeat for Chicago, which would have been possibly acceptable. This was a defeat that on a scale of 1 to 10 was a 12, a bombshell, a blow for Obama at a time when the whole world is asking whether or not the man can govern. You hear this? The man's on television day and night. Press conference, interview, town hall rally, people in the media fawning over him. 3 months in a row. And what has he achieved in the last 3 months? Nothing. Not a health care reform bill, nothing. He's done nothing. And it's pretty sad for us. Well, you say Iran has now taken part in bilateral talks with the U.S., and that's an achievement for him? Well, you're wrong. That's something that the Hitler of Iran and the mullahs of Iran have wanted for years. So Obama failed on that as well. He also threw Czechoslovakia and Poland under the bus in order to get Russian cooperation behind new sanctions against Tehran. Did he achieve anything on that? Remember I said maybe he achieved something with Russia? Wrong. 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 Because Vladimir Putin and the Chinese are opposed to sanctions on Iran. So despite all of the rhetoric and despite all the pomp, it is really nothing that he has achieved. And now, of course, you say, what does the Olympics have to do with his presidency? In my opinion, a lot, because the average person doesn't understand politics, nor are they really interested in it. It's a telegenic guy. They like him. They assume that the only reason his plans are being blocked is because of white racists who are blocking this poor, nice guy. But when they see that in their world, in their limited minds, the dodos of America who elected him, the pea brains, those who are slated for the ash heap of history because they don't even understand the world they're living in. The pea brains who elected Obama, if they understand anything, they understand sports. That's about all they understand. So in this sports game of getting the Olympics to Chicago, he threw everything on a table. You know, it would have been smart of him to have sent the wife and the TV Schmendrick, whatever her name is, Winfrey. But he shouldn't have gone. He put his entire prestige on the line. They threw him out. They said no. They made him last. So even the Schmendricks with a pea brain, the people with pea brains, the dodo birds with small wings and large heads and little brains, even they understand sports. And in the sports analogy, they understand he failed them. And one thing the dodos like is a winner. They hate losers. I think that this is a terrible blow to Obama's presidency. How about you? I'll be right back.
Savage.